My name is Joe Waring. I work for Mattamy Homes. I'm the Vice President of Strategic Procurement. Procurement is a great job. It's really fun. You get to do fun things. You get to change the way things go. But you need to make sure that you're bringing the rest of the company along. You need to make sure that they're engaged in what you're trying to do and that they buy into what you're trying to do.
Janice Davis, Senior Vice President of Supply Chain for Shaw Communication. Have that special spark. Have that something that sets you apart from others in the organization.
Hi, I'm Caroline Booth, and I'm the Chief Procurement Officer for TD Bank Group. You learn from every experience. Some of them are good, and some of them are things that you just don't want to repeat, but don't let it stop you from actually trying for that promotion or that sideways move that you think is going to be good for you.
My name is Carmen Cicerettle. I'm the IBM Canadian Procurement Executive, leading the IBM Canada Indirect Spend. If you have a passion for something, you're going to be successful, because usually when you have a passion for something, it maps to your skill set, even though we're all evolving our skill set.
First of all, everybody has their own career path, so I would never be presumptuous enough to say, this is what you need to do to progress in your career. I would say it's mostly about the fit in an organization and how you can impact positive change.
Procurement has so many tentacles into the different areas, and the more you have a broader perspective, the more you can think on your feet.
First, you should find something you really love. If you really love procurement, I would definitely recommend that people get deep knowledge in that. And actually experience lots of different industries, because one of the things you do as you go more senior and get more senior in procurement is you are driving change.
Change management is very important in procurement. Procurement is an agitator. It's a group that wants to change things, whether it's just changing a vendor out or more fundamentally changing the way that the process or the buy happens. Either way, there's an impact to the company, and you have to be sensitive to the change management issues and help lead the company through those change management issues.
The real discipline of change management is another, what I call, technical skill that will enhance while you move up the ranks.
Keeping on top of technical skills and new developments, it gets more of a challenge as you rise in your career. You don't have time to go off and take a course, and it's difficult to go to all the different symposiums that you want to go to. But still, I think on a daily basis, just talking to the other experts in your field.
The soft skills, I would actually argue, are even more important than the technical skills, primarily because you can learn technical skills. Soft skills are tougher. Soft skills are part of your DNA, and to modify those take a much greater amount of focus and effort.
I think networking is always important, whether you're in Canada or more internationally, and I don't think it's just with the procurement community, it's also across your broader organisation and obviously outside the organisation when you've got common interests.
You've got to network with your people. Everyone has different motivational points. So you have to make sure when you're a business leader, you're not just setting a strategy and hoping everyone's following it, that you got to, what we call an IBM, people need to be engaged. They need to understand that strategy, and they have to understand the value they bring in that strategy. Once you get that buy-in, people do amazing, amazing things.
Build your brand. We talked about that special spark. You want to make sure that wherever you are, you want to be that person that people want to work with.
Take that risk. Don't be risk averse. Don't fear failure to the point where it's going to stop you from doing something.
What could you be?
What could you be?
What could you be?
What could you be? What could you be?